Coming up in half an hour, we delve into the personal playlist of funny man Bob Mortimer in Orange Playlist. First on ITV1 Wales, a roundup of the latest footballing news, plus a look ahead to the weekend's fixtures. It's Soccer Night.
And welcome to Wales Soccer Night. After last weekend's FA Cup action, it's back to league duty for all three Welsh clubs. We'll be looking ahead to all the games, while former Wales international David Giles will, as usual, be giving us his expert analysis. And so too will Ian Butterworth, the former Cardiff City assistant manager, who up until September was, of course, Lenny Lawrence's right-hand man at Ninian Park. More from David and Ian later. But first, let's look ahead to the Bluebirds game against Leeds on Saturday. The last time these two sides met in October, it was a goalless draw. But Cardiff created plenty of opportunities, especially Andy Campbell.
The best of them came from the penalty spot, but Neil Sullivan was able to make the save. Campbell had other opportunities too to break his duck for the season, but the luck just wasn't going his or his side's way.
Got in swinging corner. Parry. Campbell, desperately unlucky this time. Jerome beats Sullivan, all ends up. Keeper gets a fist to it, but McInniff back in. Cardiff again unlucky.
Leeds are now within sight of a comfortable mid-table spot, 6 points clear of the City. Just one defeat in six league games now. Former Bluebird Nathan Blake with his first goal on loan from Leicester. A ruptured hamstring, though, has ruled him out of the game against his first club.
David Healy's second goal in three league games clinched the victory at Coventry. He has a touch of quality about him and provide a real test for the resurgent Gabbard-Collins combination at the heart of the City defence. It's a really big game for the Bluebirds.
Always a big game for us because it's Leeds. You know, the home game was a travesty, really. We should have won 3-0. Players responded very well. It'll always have any game between Cardiff and Leeds will always have a greater significance and importance than being 3 points. Same Saturday, really. They've revived a little bit lately. So have we. We've played pretty well the last five or six games and got some points, and we want to keep that going.
We're still nowhere near where we want to be. You know, that, as I said, that just gives us a bit of breathing space, you know, from the teams below us. But, you know, I think if we go and get a bad result now, that performances we've put in mean nothing, really, so we need to take it on.
Yeah, confidence must have been given a good boost, though, with the results.
Definitely, you know, especially, I mean, we played well against Blackburn, and you know, I think we showed we can do it against, you know, the top teams, and there's no reason why we shouldn't do it against all the teams in this league. So, as I said, we're confident, yeah.
It's a league that, if we are at our best team out and we're at our best, we don't fear anybody, and we're quite capable of getting a result. But we've only got to have a couple missing, another couple well below par, anybody can beat you. It's that sort of league. And you will find most managers say the same. 2005, the second half of the season, whichever way you want to put it, has started quite well. And, you know, we want to maintain it. We're getting back to strength and depth. You know, most of the people are coming back. We're reasonably settled. And hopefully that transfers into results. I say what all people are in our position say, I think that we are better than our points total indicates. But it's all very well keep saying it. We've got to do it. We've got to maintain it. We've started to do it, now we've got to continue.
Ian, this is a huge game for the Bluebirds, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a tough game, but they should go into the game with renewed confidence. They've had a great time over the festive period, and they've undefeated for 5 games, 3 clean sheets. They shouldn't fear Leeds at all. I'm sure that confidence will come through, and I expect them to get something on Saturday.
Let's look at the opposition Leeds. Some key players to look out for. David Healy, Brian Dean, for example.
Yeah, it's a good little partnership this is. Brian Dean's the experienced pro, be around the block a little bit. It'll be a good battle with James Collins, and we've just been seeing David Healy there score some fantastic goals. He's a good little player here, so both of them, Gavidon and Collins, will have to be on their toes on Saturday.
Gilo, you'd agree with that, wouldn't you?
Oh, totally. Ian knows the players better than most people, and what he said there, that James Collins and Gavidon will really have to be on their game. The same as all the players, you know, there'll be some key battles there with Kavanagh and Gregan in the midfield. Whoever bosses that area, you've got a good chance of winning. But it's going to be a great game. 30-odd thousand people there. It's a shame there's not more Cardiff fans going. They've only given, I think it's 1,000 tickets. I'm sure they would have taken a lot more than that.
Just talking about the set piece, if we look at any kind of crumbs of comfort for Lenny, that set piece has been a bit of a problem for Leeds in the last couple of games.
Yeah, the last couple of games have conceded some soft goals from set pieces, so if they've been practising the set pieces this week, Cardiff, they might have some joy. Leeds are usually pretty strong at that, but obviously against Crewe they've conceded 2 really daft goals, and I don't think Kevin Blackwell will be too happy with these goals.
Yeah, most definitely. Well, let's look at the table now, Gilo, because relegation is still being talked about. Have they got the squad to get them out of trouble?
Well, they certainly have, Sam. You know, the players there, you know, the, as Lenny Don has just said then, are as good as anyone on their day, but you've got to be consistent. You know, and that's where they're down there, because they've not been consistent. So a better second half of the season, and I'm sure they can climb away.
Gilo, thank you. Let's turn our attentions now to Wrexham, and what a great 2-2 draw for the Dragons on Tuesday night against Peterborough, with some fine performances from their Spanish stars. Bob Simmons is your match commentator.
Early chance then for Callum Willock to show his paces, taking on Dennis Lawrence. Only half cleared. Thompson the chance to set it up again. That's towards Logan. Willock! 2 minutes gone. Wrexham's new keeper Valero beaten then by Callum Willock. Lawrence and Pedgick, the two centre-backs, rather to blame there. Keeper well beaten. Andy Legg. This one will swing right in from the former Cardiff and Swansea man. And it's Guy Branston. 2-0 then, Peterborough, after just 12 minutes. The keeper may be at fault this time. Lack of match practice showing up. And the man on loan from Sheffield Wednesday with the bald head gets the touch. Another chance then for the Posh to send men forward. Logan couldn't quite get to it. Newton can though. Willock again. So unlucky not to make it 3. Wrexham really hanging on now desperately. Holt lining up the long throw. Coming up to the interval. Oh, and it breaks for Ugarte. Dramatically, Wrexham back in it. Thanks to the effort then of the other Spaniard on their books. Third of the season for Juan Ugarte. Takes it well. Another chance for Wrexham then to send it forward. Holt with a drive. Oh, it's 2-2. 10 minutes to go from the end. Ugarte's claiming it. Now then, was it him or Branston who got the final touch? It was a great cross anyway by Holt. And Ugarte will certainly claim it.
Well, I was pleased with the attitude that they didn't cave in. They fought back and got to result. The performance wasn't as good as I would like. I was hoping to go down there and get 3 points. But the fact is that we did show character, which is pleasing.
Big game on Saturday, Tranmere.
Well, it's a massive game. I mean, it's a local derby. They're going extremely well. You know, we played them earlier in the season, which was a cracking game, a 1-1 draw. Plenty of talking points in it. And they've taken it on from there. Unfortunately, our season's dropped away at the moment from there. We've got to get back to those standards.
How do you do that?
Well, I'm getting players back, which is a start. Which is, you know, that's a positive start. Carlos Edwards is back in contention, which he played yesterday in the reserves. and scored and did very well, and so did Deed Many. So I've got Chris Armstrong available and Steve Roberts available. So that's another four players from on top of the other night. So that's pleasing. I've got a few choices to make.
Well, I am hopeful. You know, I'm up for selection, and you know, it's up to the manager at the end of the day if he wants to put me in or not. If I get a place on the bench, it is a big positive also. And what has been an extra positive is, you know, being in the starting lineup.
Gillo, great to have Carlos Edwards back, isn't it?
Certainly is, Sam. You know, they've really missed him. He's a very, very important player. Lovely on the ball, goes past people, gets into good areas, and he scores very important goals as well. So he's been hugely missed, and with him back in the squad now, I'm sure that Wrexham can kick on.
News today about Darren Ferguson out for a couple of weeks. That's a blow, isn't it?
It is a big blow. You know, one minute they're getting a player back, the next minute they're losing someone like Darren Ferguson, who again is a smashing player for them. But as they showed at Peterborough, you know, they battled on. They showed they've got the bottle to get points, and that's a hard place to go, Peterborough. So I'm sure they can get something on Saturday.
Jolly, very briefly, just looking at the table, moved up a place, but still fighting relegation.
They're still down there, Sam. You know, they've got a huge battle on their hands, and I think it'll go right to the wire. But as long as they can show the commitment, the effort, and they've got that character to try and get results away from Oman at home, I'm sure they can get out of it.
Thanks, Gillo. Well, that's Wrexham and Cardiff City, but stay with us as we'll be looking ahead to high-flying Swansea's tie against Wickham. See you in a couple of minutes. Welcome back. Now, this time last year, the FA Cup affected Swansea City's form in the league. But as far as Kenny Jackett's concerned, he's got his priorities all worked out.
Cup games, I think, look after themselves in terms of motivation of my players and focus of the crowd. The ones I've got to work very hard on as a manager are the Wickham game at home on Saturday and then Boston away next Saturday. And, you know, emotionally, we'll have to make sure that we're right. When we played Ruston and Diamonds on Monday with the big cup game on Saturday, we didn't flinch. We focused and did the job. And we have to make sure that against Wickham and Boston that, you know, we do focus and get the most out of it. Because, you know, I've stressed to my players that the cup is fantastic, it's a terrific competition, but the league is our priority this year, and, you know, we have to know that.
Gurney from quite some distance then, and a great chance. Connor and Robinson in there. Robinson, I think, is going to claim it. What a great effort by Gurney, bouncing right in front of the keeper. Robinson just the sharpest. Second away win for Swansea coming up.
Wickham dropped more home points when they could only draw at home to Cheltenham in their last league outing. Gavin Haynes, with the second goal in three games of his first league season, gave the visitors the lead. But then former Swans man Nathan Tyson struck back. His 10th of the season. He's sure again to be quite some threat.
Southend had the opportunity to make up ground on the Swans when they travelled to Boston last night. They fell, though, to another good home effort built around Northern Ireland striker Andy Kirk. Two second-half goals made it 14 for the season in 16 league games. A free transfer sign-in from Hearts this season, what a bargain.
Southend then still trailed the Swans by 4 points, but have now played a game more. A bit of a gap developing there. A chance for the Swans maybe to pull away.
Gillo, Swansea still third in the table, but at the end of the day, the top three will be promoted, won't they?
That's right, Sam. There's a bit of a gap appeared as well there. But I still think the Swans have got their eyes on winning that title. And if they keep playing the way they are, I'm sure they've got a very good chance of it.
Ian, plenty of transfer talks at the moment. Andy Burgess, the bid has been rejected by Rushton. Is he worth more?
Well, obviously, Ken will be looking to strengthen his side and obviously add the goals tally, improve the goals tally from midfield. And this lad, I think he's played over 200 times for Rushton. I've seen him a couple of times while watching other, when I've been on scouting duties. I've watched him a few times and he's not bad. And I think maybe 50 grand, 75 grand is about right, really. And I think he'd be a useful addition to the Swan squad.
What about Mark Goodfellow then, Gillo?
Yes.
He certainly made his mark at the Vetch, hasn't he?
He certainly did, Sam. You know, I saw him in a few games. I think he scored 4 goals while he was on loan there. It was a player probably doing nothing at Bristol City, and come the end of the season, they may have released him. He's going to Swansea on loan. kick-start his career again and start his scoring goals. Now Bristol City want money for him, but he's a player that Swansea could do with because he's got this knack, as Ian said, scoring goals, vitally important.
Ian, Wickham have signed the legendary player Steve Claridge. He's an old head. He's going to be quite instrumental, isn't he, on the weekend?
Yeah, I mean, I remember playing with Steve Claridge for many years ago, and he does know where the net is, and he's not bad with his socks around his ankles there, is he? Look at him there. I mean, he is a threat, and, you know, if he plays, you know, you just can't give him a yard in that penalty box because he's got the quality to stick the ball in the net, even at that inch.
And, of course, home game at the Vetch. Those fans will be supporting the Swans.
Oh, I'm sure they will, Sam. There'll be a big crowd again there on Saturday. And then they've got the bonus of the return leg in the cup match against Reading. So exciting times for Swansea at the moment, and I'm sure they want to keep it going.
Indeed it is. Thanks, Gilo. Well, there's only a few weeks to go now before the Carling Cup final at the Millennium Stadium. This week, in the semi-finals, it was a goalless draw at Stamford Bridge when Chelsea took on Manchester United, while Liverpool beat Watford 1-0. So let's look at all the action.
No breakthrough yet, but that is Pongol. And this is Barros, newly introduced. Milan Barros for Liverpool. Jones got a hand on it. Gerrard followed up, and Gerrard scored! Finally, despite the valiant efforts on the line of Neil Cox, Steven Gerrard, Liverpool's driving force, has driven them into the lead in the semi-final, courtesy to a large degree of the newly introduced Milan Barros. Gerrard, 1-0.
Sent Bridge into a spin. Now Fletcher. All the way across to Luis Saha, who's faced by Paulo Ferreira. And then he goes down, but rather hurled himself, and the referee, just with a quick shake of the head, says a decisive no.
Well, it was a great ball from Fletcher to find Saad to begin with. I thought he was looking for it far too easily.
Big game, big occasion. Here's Duff. And Duff has a goal! And it would have been a goal to grace a special occasion.
Well, Tim Howard seemed to react very comfortably to it, but judging by Damien Duff's reaction, it was a lot closer. It looked, I mean, he struck it really, really well. That was very, very close, and I think Howard's getting absolutely nowhere near that, completely caught out by it. It's a good, good try.
Rooney. Terry. Wayne Rooney! And they still carry a threat, however much pressure they're having to soak up.
I think Gallus could have reacted quicker to this. You know, he backed off it, and Terry had to come all the way across. I think it might have taken a nick off Gallus on the way out as well, because Rooney did appeal for a corner.
And Cole! Well, we know that Manchester United are susceptible to snapshots from distance. But this time, the goal line wasn't called into play.
Well, how lucky is he? I mean, I could understand it from Tim Howard if he's under pressure and he has to deal with it quickly.
Makalele. Thiago. Duff. And now Lampard, and that's beautifully done by Lampard. And Frank Lampard is denied by Ainsley on the line. Wonderful weaving run by Chelsea's England midfield player.
I just think this is brilliant football all round. It's a great little ball by Damien Duff. Very, very clever from Frank Lampard, even more so then. And Ainsley does so well to get behind his beaten goalkeeper.
Good strike, Lampard!
Well, it's the gaping hole that will concern United at the back, because really, when John O'Shea's contesting this, Ainsley should be tucked in, Sylvester should be quicker to it. He's usually pretty deadly from that kind of range.
But now, 9 hours and 31 minutes since Manchester United last conceded a goal. There's a chance, though, and it's a goal-line clearance to deny Jaroszik.
Well, it's the second. I think it's Phil Neville. I mean, Howard gets across well.
So, Gilo, who do you fancy in the final then at the Millennium Stadium?
I think you've still got to go for Liverpool. I think that they've done enough to win the game now. I'm sure they won't be as bad again at Watford. And I think Manchester United are going to sneak it against Chelsea. Great side, but I think Chelsea got too much on their plate. But in all competitions, the league is what they want, but United need to win something as well.
Now, Ian, it's been about 4 months since you left Cardiff City. What have you been up to in the last couple of months?
Not a lot, really. I've been scouting for a few teams in the lower leagues, two or three teams. So I've been watching plenty of football and just applying for jobs and hopefully try and get back into the game.
Is it tough not being part of a club on a day-to-day basis? Yeah, and missing it?
Yeah, you do miss it. It's hard. It's been your life since you were, you know, 16, so it's pretty tough. But, you know, you have to put up with these things in football, take on the chin. You have some downs as well as the ups, so hopefully something will come up soon.
From your point of view, what would you like to do if someone said, right, here we go, Ian, here's the plan on the table?
Well, I'd like to get back into coaching. I'd like to manage. That's the ultimate my ultimate ambition. So, you know, them two things I'm going to be aiming for.
Yeah, I mean, you know Ian very well, Gilo. I mean, he's missed at Cardiff City.
Oh, without a doubt. You know, Ian's got great qualities. Speaking to him earlier on, he knows everything about the game. He knows the players. Very good coach. He's young enough to still get back in there and do a job. And I'm sure as long as he keeps believing in himself, keeps applying for jobs, something will come along for him. I'm sure everybody in Cardiff especially wishes him all the best, and I'm sure we'll see him, but they're both back in football soon.
Must be quite interesting on a positive note over the last couple of months, just watching lots of football and seeing some young up-and-coming players.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, it gives you, you know, the variety of all levels of watching all teams, you know, straight from the second division up to the Premier League as well, you know, and I've been lucky enough to, you know, you've got contacts in the game to watch these players and watch the teams, and you know, you're looking all the time and you're learning all the time, so it's been a... Well, it's been a nice rest for about two or three days, but I prefer to be back in the action.
Very briefly, Gilo, how do you rate our side's chances this weekend?
Yeah, I can see Cardiff definitely gets something. A win would be brilliant, but I can see him getting a point. I think the Swans will win, and fingers crossed Wrexham will win as well.
And let's hope so. My thanks to you both. That's all we've got time for this week, and of course my thanks to David Giles and Ian Butterworth for joining me in the studio. Good luck to all three teams on the weekend. We'll be back at the same time, of course, at 11:30 next Thursday. Hope you can join me then. But from all of us on Wales Soccer Night, goodbye.